If he say he don't want me back, he'd be lying. Bitch, I'm the source.
Barbie dipping.
I'm the boss.
Barbie sipping.
They keep telling me work it. I ain't got.
Okay, guys. So the most important thing that I would say when you're about to start doing your makeup is that your skin is clean. And not like, you know, when you have like little crusties and stuff on your skin, it's just gonna show through. Like literally it's just gonna be like little pieces of makeup falling off of your little skin pieces. So I really think you don't have to wash your face if you feel like your face is clean already, but you know, I would definitely suggest washing your face before you start your makeup. Then the next step after you've done your skincare, whatever, is to get a good primer. So the primer that I like to use is this Crooked. Like I can't even tell, I literally can't tell. Okay, so the next step would be to get you a good primer. Okay, so this one is really cheap. It's from the drugstore. It's Maybelline. I also like to use the Porefessional sometimes. I cannot find it, but I'm just gonna use this one today. It basically does the same thing. It's like blurring, smoothing. A good, like if you have really textured skin, like you wanna get something that's gonna like combat that, you know? And a lot of these primers will just tell you what they do on them. A primer really isn't, I don't know, I'm not gonna say primer is not essential, but I feel like you could do your makeup without having primer, but you should get primer. After I do my primer, I like to set it with the powder. I used to be using this all over my face before I put on my foundation. This is like translucent powder. I mean, you could do that. It doesn't really make your makeup look crazy or anything, but I just feel like I get better results when I use a powder that's closer to my skin tone. So I'm gonna do that and I'll be right back. Yeah, it looks a little bit ghastly, but It's not the final look, guys. You know, makeup looks bad before it looks good. You always remember that. Okay, so now after you look like Casper, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take some setting spray. I use setting spray a lot of times throughout my makeup routine, but this is only the first time I use setting spray in my routine. But I just don't like, I got this trick from Jackie Aina, and she doesn't use setting spray after she does it, but I just feel like this gives cakey, and I just don't think it's a vibe for me, so I'm just gonna spray it. This is what I usually do. I spray it and then I take the beauty blender again and I just pack it in. So I'm gonna do that. Okay, I'm gonna need y'all to not even clown me this whole video, because I'm gonna look like this for a little while because I'm talking. Okay, after you pat in all that setting spray, you know, have the face still looking ghostly, but you know, about to start getting into it. So one thing I would say is that highlight and contour is a necessity. I know that some people just put on foundation. I know some people do that, but I just feel like that. It gives a flat look. It gives a flat look, like, you know, when you're doing your highlight and your contour, you're bringing back in the highs and lows of your face so that it looks, you know, back to like a real face. Because when you put on foundation, it just blurs out everything on your face and it just looks like one thing. And that's not how a real face looks, you know, so yeah. But starting off with the actual foundation though, I feel like everybody should be using a full coverage foundation. That's just my opinion. Like if you're gonna do your makeup, do it, you know? That's if you're really doing your makeup though. Like, you know, natural looks, everyday looks, that's something different. But when you're really gonna do your makeup, it should be a full coverage foundation. And I feel like that contributes to the overall look of it. Like, if you're using like a sheer foundation and then you put in highlight and contour, I don't know how. I never tried it personally. If that possibly could work for some people, but personally, I feel like full coverage is the way to go, because you can easily lighten it up or really pack it on so you can get that coverage. So it's really up to you, your preference, but this is just, you know, my video, what I'm doing for you guys. And these are the two foundations that I'm gonna be using today. So I'm starting off, well, I'm not starting off, I'm gonna be mixing them, because this one is really like close to my, this is basically my skin tone, but this one is really the coverage that I need. So I'm just gonna mix them. So I'm gonna be using the NYX Total Control Drops. This is in the shade Deep Sable. I don't even know if this is still made. This is so old, like years. But you know, still going strong, because I've been using different foundations all the time. But yeah. And this is the next one that I'm gonna be using. It's the Maybelline Super Stay. Yeah, these are the two that I'm gonna be using. And I'm gonna mix them to my face, and I'm gonna be back to talk more to you guys. Okay, one comment I will make about doing your foundation is that you need to use like one of these motions, you know, like packing it in, pressing it in more so than like a swirling motion, because let me tell you, the swirling, it's not doing a thing for you. It's not doing a thing for you. It's not blending it. It's just moving it. It's just moving it. That's all it's doing. So pack that thing. Pack it in, light it, okay? Okay, so the next step is highlight or contour, whatever order you wanna do it in, but personally, I like to do my highlight first. So recently, I've been liking the brightened look more. Like it's not OD bright, but it's like more bright than what I was doing before. So what I'll do is, I'll take a concealer that's like closer to my foundation, and I'll take one that's a bit lighter, and I'll start off with the one that's my skin tone, and I'll start placing that first. And you really don't want to use something that's way too light. Like, that should be common sense, but I really think that it's not. Like, a lot of people don't know that. Like, that just wouldn't look right. In a picture, really in real life either, like, you just look white. Not white, but too light. Too not the color that you're supposed to be. Like, highlight is supposed to just bring it forward a little. Bring it forward. If you put in white concealer and you my skin tone, you need to reevaluate that. I'm sorry. And I love you guys. That's why I'm talking to y'all like this. I love y'all. I want y'all to look good. So we can be bad bitties together. All right. So after that, the one that's your skin tone, you're going to go in with the lighter one. In the middle, like basically making the same shape a little smaller, but really don't OD, because this can get out of hand really fast and it can just start to mess up your whole makeup. So really be careful, guys. Be careful. Okay. All right. So after that, I like to do my highlight and my contour lines at the same time. Some people don't like that. Some people like to blend it out first, but I like to let one sit while I'm blending out the other. Like, while I'm doing this, this is sitting. And when I'm blending this out, that's sitting. And then I blend that out, and it's all blended up, you know? So that's how I like to do it. So with the darker concealer, I have these two by e.l.f. I really like these concealers. I really do. They really give me ColourPop vibes, but they're so cheap and so good. But I'm gonna have these two. This one, I don't really like her. Rich Cocoa. It's a bit too gray on my skin. But this one, I don't know what it is. It gives me that real nice, like that real contour. Like, you know, some contours, especially for black girls, like they don't really carve out your face. Like, it just blends in. But this is really dark. This is dark. And I like that. I really do. So I'm gonna do my contour lines. And then I'm gonna do my contour lines and then I'll be done. Actually, another thing, I know I said I like my contour dark, but you really don't want to go too dark because then it starts to look like muddy. Like your face will like, it will look like you're, like it's just, no matter how well it's blended, it's just gonna look harsh and muddy. Like you don't want to go too dark. This is probably like two shades darker than me. Three, probably. But it's not too dark. I'm gonna show you guys when I put it on. But yeah, I just wanted to come back and say that because I don't want y'all out here looking crazy. Okay, so see my two little lines right there, right? Then I'm gonna, I gotta wipe some off because I don't want to do this part too much. You just flick it up a little bit. That just a little bit, flick it upwards, so you know you're gonna blend that upwards so that your face is getting, you know, lifted up. And on the nose, I really go like, in my last video I did the most. Y'all saw me blending that. I was blending that for like 30 minutes or so. But I try to go light on the nose. And then I do my chin too. Because I have like a huge, like when I smile, my chin is like, it just goes down. You know, like it's big. So yeah, I like to do a little something right there. So this is how my face looks after the whole shebang highlight contour. I didn't even do my nose right here. Look at me. So after you have that, I like to blend out my highlight with a brush. Personally, I did it one time with the brush and I never went back to the beauty blender. Like, it just, I don't know, like it blends it into the foundation way better. Like the beauty blender takes away some of your makeup, this just blends it all out nicely. You just blend it all in, and I just feel like it gives it a more seamless look compared to the beauty blender. So yeah, I'm gonna blend it out and I'm gonna show you guys. You guys tell me what you think. If you like your beauty blender, comment. Tell me what you think. If you like a brush, you know, whatever. But I like the brush for my blending out my highlight. Do y'all see this? Like, do y'all see that? This brush, this, no matter what you're doing, this is the, I mean, no matter what brand it is, whatever, this is the shape of the brush you need. Get it right there. Like, it gets it so nice and so easily. Like, I literally love it. Like, wow. Okay, so after I blend out my highlight, looking pretty good. After I blend that out, I blend out my contour. So I like to use this brush. Oh, this is nice. I like to do some sort of angled brush, but I gotta find it because this is new. It's like a stiff, like one of those kabuki brushes, but it's angled. And what I like to do, I don't have to make the face, but I want to make the face, okay? So I like to do that face, and then I blend it, obviously with the angled side, and upwards, blend it going up. Up into the highlight. You see how you can see, like this contour is dark, but it's not AOD. Like obviously I'm not even done blending it yet, but you see it's just blending in nicely. And I try not to bring this down too far. Well, see, I still do the carving thing, but I try not to bring it down too far because I just don't want to have to deal with blending that out. And then I like to take, when I'm blending this out, I take the little excess and put it on my forehead. I don't cut a whole line on my forehead because I be wearing wigs and it already makes my forehead smaller. So I don't want to do too much, you know, I make it look crazy. Okay, then for the nose, the type of brush I like to use is, of course, I can never find anything when I'm on camera. Like, that's crazy. This house. Oh, it's right here. Okay, so this is the type of brush I like to use for my nose. It's another angled brush. You guys can see that. It looks like that. My lines in my hand look so big. Oh my gosh, looks so much on there. But yeah, I like to use this, and I start from the bottom, blend it up right into the front of my eyebrow. So after you're blending out, so after you're done blending out all of your creams, you're gonna start setting your face with powders. So I like to start off with my lightest powder, which would be the highlight powder. And I'm gonna be using the Maybelline Fit Me in Medium Deep. I love this powder. And I'm gonna use a beauty blender for the powder because I like the way it makes that sit. Cause if we're talking body, you got a perfect one to put it on me. Swear you won't let me love if you love me back. Okay, so after I do the highlight powder, I take a pressed powder that's my face shade and I go over my whole face with a big fluffy brush, but not the places that I just highlighted, just the rest. And after that, I take my contour powder last and I blend that out. Well, I set my contour with the powder. It goes on. Okay, so after I set my contour, that's when I finally blend out my highlight powder. Thank you. now, after you wiped away that excess powder, that's when the setting spray comes in again. So you're gonna spray that to just lighten up all that powder you just put on your face, okay? Okay, so after you put on the setting spray and you press it in with the Beauty Blender, that's when you're gonna start on the finishing touches of your makeup. So that would be, that would be blush, highlight, you know, your lips, or whatever. So I'm always using this NYX Sweet Cheeks blush. It's really cute. Nothing major. Please smile. Let me just plop it on. And I love blush. Like, do you see the difference in my face right now? I literally love blush. Like, I just love it. I'm sorry. I'm a blush fiend. Love it. It's so cute. Then I'm going to be using this highlighter that I got in an Ipsy bag. It's called Koki Soft Glow. And I'm just going to put that right here. Right here. Right here. And right here. And this is just the first round of blush and highlight. Because I do another round of setting spray and another round of blush and highlight to really make it show. So yeah, after that, setting spray again. Setting spray again. And then I go in with my foundation brush. A little bit after dry, a little bit after dry. Pressing in that setting spray really, really does something. So I do more, a little bit more blush after that. Just a little bit after it. And then a little bit more highlight. To make it really pop. Yes, really pop. Oh, yes, girl. All right, guys, so that's really it for the face, honestly. So I'm gonna go do my little finishing touches, do my hair, whatever, come back a little bit cuter, and I'll see you guys. Okay, guys, this is my finished face. You know, I went and put on a little lip gloss, a little mascara. It's okay. If you guys have any questions, comment down below. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Let me know what you guys want to see next, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.